Good. I think this is recording. Good. Hello, good evening. It is a Sunday night. It's about 11 o'clock. I really need to go to bed, but I thought I penciled in this time in my diary to go bang! Fan formula. It's every week. You know that. Firstly, I'm not by a river as I was last week. I'm in more stable surroundings, not with the water going around me. Firstly, happy birthday to Tiff, who was, I'm not going to say how old she was, she may have mentioned it in the last video, so you're going to have to watch that, so you're going to have to watch the video, which is hilarious and brilliant and excellent stories. So I'm not going to tell you, but happy birthday, Tiff. Many happy returns. Hope you've got lovely presents. And old age isn't that bad, really. No flim-flam this week, because I'll explain at the end of the video. Let's go on with it. Transfer time, it's all silly season, everyone's going mad. Question one, as announced for the Singapore Grand Prix, Jake Humphrey is upping sticks and going to the BT to present Premier League football. Yes, who do you think would be the best replacement for him for the 2013 season? Me! Why not me? And if not me, anybody else that does fan formula, anybody else that sits in front of the internet and says their views on Formula 1, that's passionate about Formula 1, would make a perfect fit. I don't like all these people that have been in motorsport before and really obscure people. Who are they? No, just get someone like really, really obscure and go, they're going to be brilliant. So, yeah, anybody I'd put forward in the fan Formula community. In fact, we could all take turns at doing it. And we've got a Scottish connection and like Lee McKenzie. So, it's all good, frankly. Realistically, I don't know. Maybe the guy from MotoGP that I can't remember his name, Matt, is it Matt? Might be Matt. Other than that, I don't know. I hope David Coulthard doesn't become the anchorman, because I don't think he's a very good anchorman, and his chin would get in the way of the camera. As you can see, I'm sporting my F1 beard watch, Ross Brawn, this week, you may have noticed, so for all you beardophiles out there, or progonophiles is actually the term, progonophiles. Well, welcome to my beard. It will all come off tomorrow morning, so make the most of it while you can. On a realistic note, I don't know who might replace him. It could be a load of people. I don't know. I hope it's someone good, and I hope it continues as it is to be very good. Although I do watch Sky, so I don't know. It could be anything. Although Vicky and I are thinking of doing a TV program for F1, it's in the pipeline. I'm just going to say it might be like with Sparky and Perky, or it may not. I mean, there are many working titles to it. But yeah, I mean, anybody would be good at it. Anybody in our little fan Formula-like community would be excellent at presenting Formula 1, I think. Question two, the obvious question, Hamilton to Mercedes, what's your view? Firstly, he went to Mercedes. just the sheer amount of psychotic hate on Twitter for people that are annoyed at this decision by way of Hamilton moving, fine, it's his decision, by way of Schumacher being uplifted, the Schumacher fans went crazy. This Nikita girl who I was introduced by someone so they don't get shot when I tell their name, thank you, Paige. Yeah, and also back to question one, I don't think, I think people that do videos would be better at presenting Formula One. Not these sort of, these pseudo F1 bloggers that take all of their, like, bits, like a chunk out of Sky and a chunk out of BBC and then mash it together and set it their own, and that magically come up with race reports 2 weeks before the race has been finished. I'm not mentioning any names, but the surnames may rhyme with Wesley, that's what I'm saying. But back to question two. Hamilton went. I think it's time at McLaren. I think he wants a competitive car, and he was just frustrated at McLaren, and McLaren were frustrated with him. So I think there were many champagne corks popping in the Whitmarsh household of sort of going, this guy's been a liability, we need to shift him, and it's good that he's gone. Bad news though, that Ron Dennis didn't know, or apparently didn't know, and that the Paris Motor Show, when they revealed the P1, which by the way, a stonkingly good car, probably will be, but it looks amazing. And he was in all the, Hamilton was in all the publicity material for the Paris Motor Show for this new car. And you think that's a bit awkward the day before he announces that it gets a bit tetchy. I think he went because Ross Brawn basically said, I think, I know I disagree with Paige on this one, but Ross Brawn went into Honda and fettled about for a few years with mediocrity, ready for 09, and then bang, it went in, and you knew what happened. So it was a mighty, mighty, mighty season. Lost me 26 grand, not go into that, but, or didn't win me 26 grand, I didn't lose 26 grand, that'd be ridiculous, I'd be mad. But I think Hamilton went to Mercedes because of that sort of 2014, big engine change, big rule change, and Ross Brawn's been really fettling with it. So I think he'll produce a good car. Then the report we've had in the Hindustan Times this week of Bernie Ecclestone saying, oh, actually we're going to throw these new engine rules out the window. Hamilton's buggered in that case, because that's all I think he went to Mercedes for in a racing point of view. From a commercial point of view, I think they're going to give him a bit of a longer lead when it comes to sponsorship and who he can go, and he can get money from bigger sources elsewhere rather than McLaren going, you have to be in Santander, you have to be in Vodafone, you have to be in Boss or whoever these people happen to be in the sponsors, and Lucozade and whoever else is on the car, and Mobile One and people like that. You have to be in this thing. But I was also reading on Twitter, because you're all magic people, about, you know, what will happen to Tuned now? What will happen to the, and then what will be the demographic for like the last bit of the season? And it's gonna, and then Lewis Hamilton, oh, Jensen Button unfollowing Lewis Hamilton. For the record, people, I'm not gonna quote you on this, but I don't think he was following him to start with. So this whole, oh, he unfollowed him, was a bit of a blown out of all proportion. But we'll have to wait and see for that. I don't know. The whole, there's not going to be a number one driver, even though Hamilton's going to think he wants the number one driver, but then Rosberg's going to go in his really boring German way, because he's the most boring person in the world, apart from Paul de Resta. He's going to want the number one driver, because he's been there at Mercedes for longer, and he's German, and it's going to be an interesting demographic between the two of them. So we'll look forward to that. I mean, I hope Ross Brawn's the sort of person that just goes, poof, and bashes their head together occasionally. But we'll see. Question three. Do you think the Perez made a good decision to go to McLaren? Or should he continue on his Ferrari-backed career? I think with Massa, well, we think Massa's staying at Ferrari for 2013. Vettel, we're pretty sure, has a pre-contract with Maranello for 2014. So Massa's going to get kicked out at the end of 2013 season, and Vettel's going to go into a Ferrari seat. There was no way for Vettel to go, or there's no way for Perez to go, even on the Ferrari program. He can't go anywhere because all the factory Ferrari seat is full for the next goodness knows how many years now, if we are to be believed. So I think it was the only option for Perez, if he wants to forward his career, to go to a team. I mean, it was either Mercedes, Red Bull, McLaren or Ferrari. But he can't go to Red Bull because Red Bull are Red Bull. But he'd have to wait to go in 2014. But then I think one of the junior drivers is going to pop up from Toro Rosso and Mark Webber. So it's all going to be, Red Bull's going to go up in the air, but I think it's going to be bringing up teams. Mercedes have already sorted themselves out, and Ferrari are not going to give him a seat because Vettel's got it. So I think the only option for him to progress his career from Sauber was to go to McLaren, and with a McLaren seat free, it made a logical decision for me, and I think for the future as well, because Jenson Button will be a great mentor, not as in like a pompous way, but in sort of just to make him feel comfortable, and he won't mind if he gets beaten occasionally. Yes, he's still a very motivated man, but Jenson Button's content, I think, with what he's doing. I mean, we saw we'll see what happens with that, but I think it's a good decision for McLaren, it's a good decision for Button, it's a good decision for Whitmarsh, and especially for Perez, and also the sponsorship that with Vodafone looking maybe at a get out and readjusting their global sort of advertising budget, wanting a get out maybe from McLaren, Telmex as a telecommunications company and Mexico could come straight in to McLaren and be the title sponsor for McLaren next season. We don't know, but I think with Perez, it's a high likelihood. So that's question two. Bonus question. We love the bonus question. With the seat now effectively empty at Sauber, who do you think will fill Perez's boots? Me! because I have Ferrari racing shoes, as you've seen, or you may not have seen, actually. I may not have shown you them. But I'd be good in Sauber. It'd be brilliant. Peter Sauber, way before silly season all kicked off, said, you know, if Michael Schumacher's free, we'll give him a seat. So maybe Schumacher's going to Ferrari. Schumacher going to Ferrari for 2013 is just sort of a year cameo and then retire. Who knows? We don't know. I mean, I'm sure the Schumacher fans will go psychotic on Twitter. We're not sure. But I think maybe a race seat at Sauber if he wants to continue his failed comeback. So maybe you go to Sauber and bash it with Kobayashi. We're not entirely sure. So I think maybe Schumacher is... or maybe Alguersuari to go into, because he's not very good as a commentator. He's better as a driver, because I'm not really understanding what he's saying with commentary. Yeah, he's a former driver, but that doesn't mean he's a good commentator. But yes, he drives, but he's not very good in the media. So I think Alguersuari or Schumacher for Sauber's seat. Yeah, for Perez's seat. Yep, that's it from me. Just like to say, look after yourself this week. I know I will, hopefully, touch wood. I know I say that, don't anything I wouldn't do. Lastly, I'm going through big changes in my life currently. Not deep and meaningful, but just quite flippant, because you know I'm not serious like that. I'm not getting married or anything like that, that'd be ridiculous. Although that'd be fun. Anyone want to marry me, you know, feel free. Bye. So this might be, and I'm not making this up, this isn't me being fatuous, this might be my last fan formula for 2 months, due to these big upheavals. Of course, I will try my utmost to get questions and do, even if it's a slight video in the back of a moving train or in a cafe somewhere, try and get it done. But this may be my last sort of proper one for a good while. So I have to say, it has been an absolute pleasure, a privilege, and an absolute ball to work with you, to say my thoughts into a webcam, and we'll see what happens. You know, I could go all through the soliloquy and goodness knows next week everything will be fine and everything will be put back together and I'll be bashing one of these out, but we don't know. So I just thought I'd warn you now and apologise in advance for my possible absence over the next couple of months. So I think the look after yourselves this week, and look after yourselves until we meet again. So I think on that bombshell, after nearly 13 minutes, no, I've done 13 minutes, didn't have a script this week. I shall bid you farewell, and I hope we meet again sooner rather than later. So look after yourselves and see you soon.